We're going to show you the basics of using text in Premiere Pro, such as how to add it, formatting, effects, masks, and how to use the legacy title feature. Use the clickable sections to skip to these parts. To add text to your project, first select the Type tool by clicking on the T icon in the toolbar next to your timeline. You can also use the keyboard shortcut by typing the letter T. You'll now be able to drag your cursor across the screen to create a text box like this. Your text box will appear as a graphic layer on your timeline, which you can move, extend, or shorten. Now click inside the text box and start typing to add your text. To change the size of your text box, click on the selection tool from the toolbar next to your timeline here, or press V on your keyboard. Now drag the corners of the text box to resize. Click and drag to change the text position. To format your text, first select your text box. From the right-hand side of your screen, now click on the Essential Graphics tab, and then Edit. Be sure to check that your text is highlighted. Now you can change the format of the text, including the font, size, and orientation. You can align the text perfectly to the horizontal center of the frame by selecting the icon here. You can perfectly align to the vertical center of the frame by selecting the icon here. To change the color, click on the colored box next to Fill. Select the color you want from the color picker and then click OK. If you want to add an outer stroke, background, or shadow to your text, click the check mark here and select your desired color. You can change the density of the outer stroke by changing the number here. You can add effects and transitions to your text layer on the timeline in the same way that you would a normal layer. Let's add a cross dissolve to either side so that the text gradually appears and disappears. From the right-hand side, go to the Effects tab, and then under the Video Transitions drop-down, find Dissolve, and then Cross Dissolve. Click and drag the effect from the menu onto your text layer on the timeline. The effect has now been applied to your text. You can change the duration of the transition by clicking and dragging the effect like this. Repeat on the other side of the text clip to cross dissolve out. You can add a mask to your text by selecting the layer in the timeline and clicking on one of the shape icons under the opacity section in the top left window. Let's add a square mask. It will now appear on the monitor here. Click and drag to move it, or drag the blue squares in the corners to resize. To use the legacy title feature, select File at the top, and then New and Legacy Title. Give your title a name and choose its width, time base, and pixel aspect ratio. You'll be able to change these later. You'll now see the legacy title window. You'll see all the options for adjustment here. Your legacy title will appear as a layer in your project window. Drag onto your timeline, and you'll be able to move, shorten, extend, or add effects to it, just the same as a normal layer or text layer.